Hi and welcome to United World Week Day 2. Today I would like to introduce to one of our hosts, Sissel Trasto. She is a BBA student and a very productive and enthusiastic gem from the circular.
Hi everyone, let me introduce you to my co-host, who is Gilen. Gilen is a special educator by profession and she has been a part of Populare since age 5.
So, Sissel, what do we mean by Why for You 00 or United World Week?
Gilen, Youth for United World are young people who live for a more fraternal and united world. We want universal brotherhood to become the new cornerstone for politics, economics, labor, environment, sports, communication, and science. We are thousands of young people who follow this lifestyle by putting into practice the golden rule. Do to others what you want them to do unto you, and don't do to others what you don't want them to do unto you.
Since 1996, we have been organizing the United World Week annually. United World Week involves children, youth, and adults in activities, conventions, campaigns, and cultural exchanges amid and impacting public opinion in their own society. It generates a wide-scale shared testimony that a united world is possible, leaving a lasting mark on people, cities, and institutions.
We start at a local level in our own cities by developing projects to face the problems we find around us. And this brings us to our today's event. After having conducted a survey among young people, we found that the pandemic we are living with makes us all struggle with an uncertain future, with a fear to get infected, with the pain of losing people close to us. We are struggling, especially as young people. Therefore, we thought it is necessary to give voice to what we go through and reflect with the help of some experts on how to deal with it. But this is for later. Firstly, let us welcome one and all gathered here in this Zoom meeting and also those who are following us through YouTube.
We have from various cities like Mumbai, Goa, Bangalore, Delhi. A special welcome to all our friends also from Sri Lanka, Nepal, the Philippines, and many other places around the world. Today, we'll have our program in two sets. Our program is divided into two parts. First, after some warm-up on motion, we will have an input by Dr. Avinash, followed by Marek Loma. He will also help us enter into the topic of managing emotions. After their short presentations, you will also have the possibility to write down questions into our Padlet. Through this question and answer session, we will have some input into our session. The second part of our program is when we will split up into breakout rooms, where through the help of your moderators in the group, we'll have a chance to be active and discuss among ourselves solutions and situations that we all go through. So I invite everyone to write questions into the Padlet. A Padlet is a screen as you can see right now. You just have to go to the app and find Padlet. Then you can log in. Then you choose a membership and there you will find different bookmarks that we have created for today's session. So I'm sure everyone is going through different emotions and all, but just to lighten us up, we will have a short game by Rahul. So Rahul, over to you.
Firstly, let me explain you the code of conduct. Before we start, just a reminder to all to please keep your mics on mute. And you can open them only for answering the question and answers and in your breakout rooms. And let's live our motto of this United World Week, Dare to Care. Let's care for one another and help each other in this enjoyable meeting where our golden rule is really put into practice. Let's do it all together. Thank you.
Thanks, I think. Thanks, Gillian. Thanks, Crizelle, for this. I think we have some international friends also out here. So wave hi from India. out here, and for sure y'all can in the chat you can mention the country you are from, so it will be easy for us also to know. Without any delay, I'll take you to this interesting game called as Managing Emotions, which is based on the theme, and it's a very simple game. No need to worry on it, and the rules are quite simple. The rules are that there are no rules. It's just that some historic images will pop up on the screen. So without any thought, just take like not even like too much of time, 5-10 seconds, just see the image, whatever you feel, type the answer in the chat. All right, it can be a single word, it can be a phrase, or even a sentence. All right, let's go. If yes, you can just type hi, yes, in the chat, or you can show some emoji of heart or smiley face, which I can actually see. Great, thanks. So let's go with the first image, and tell me, what are they feeling? You can, of course, I think I'll need a moderator, your Daphne or Ghislaine. Anyone can help me to read if people are typing the answer in chat, because I cannot see it while I'm on the full screen.
I'll let you know the comments from YouTube. So those in YouTube watching on YouTube, you can type in your answers in the chat box in the comment section. Thank you.
And also in our chat box. Yeah. Great. So I think multiple answers are popping in. So I'll tell you the right answer later on. But there is no right and wrong. It's just to understand what are they feeling. Yes, the next image is what are they feeling again. So yeah, we will keep 10 seconds for each image, and you can keep typing your answer. Okay? Next image is here. Without even giving a thought, it can be funny, it can be anything you feel. It's your choice. Okay, I'll go next. All right. What is this gentleman feeling? The reason to take this image was because I liked his hairstyle, and he was looking quite cute to me. So I'll go next. His mustache is quite interesting. So again, Daph, can you see some answers if they are flowing in? Feel free to even open your mic and let the answer know. To be the first one, you can just...
Pride, confidence, lazy, tricky, smug, gotcha, alert, feeling lucky, angry, oversmart and confident, sad, exhausted, cool.
Well, I'll go to the next one.
This is 10 second lag on YouTube. How dare you?
Guys, you can open your mic and speak also.
John, can you read out in the chat box what is written? Because there's lots coming in.
Stubborn, stunned, annoyed. Why would you get away from me?
The way my brother feels when I take the last piece of chicken. You what?
All right, Nick. What is he feeling?
Ambushed. No, scared, grossed out, saw a ghost, afraid, it wasn't me. Oh, scared again, scared, save me.
So my favorite image, it reminds me of Marco's head at the moment.
No, dying, get away from me, Voldemort. Arey, yaar, Voldemort didn't have a nose, sarcastic, gotcha, evil. Gotcha. malicious, cunning, shrewd, airbender. Avatar, the last airbender. Okay. Mocking someone's laugh. Cunning. My precious.
Well, I'll go next.
Hey, Planet of the Apes.
He looks very cute, no?
Just resemblance? Foul. Foul resemblance?
Yeah, looks like my lost brother.
I love you. Give me a kiss. Oof, oof. How guys look at girls? No comments.
On YouTube, people are commenting, scared, crafty, laughing at a joke, clever.
It's hot.
Interesting.
Enjoying.
I'll go next. So now let's go to the answers. And the image one was STC. Then the third one, the second one was of thoughtful and suspicious. Third was hostile. Fourth was horrible. Fifth was grief. Sixth was violence. Seventh was fear. Eighth was laughter. And ninth was disappointed or sully. So pat your backs. If you've given a right answer, I'm sure when we meet, I'll give a hug to each one of you all as a gift. So thanks. And over to the MCs here.
Thanks, Rahul, so much for this game. We will now have a short poll since we are of different ages. In Zoom, we are all the youth, but we have many on YouTube who are watching us who belong to different ages. And we are in different walks of life as well. So we have a short poll. For the ones on Zoom, you can select your answer and submit your poll. For the ones on YouTube, I'll be reading it out. And you can type which of the options suit you best and put it into chat so we can see it. So the first question is, do I tend to focus more on the positive or negative traits of others? The three options are positive traits of others, sometimes both positive and negative, and the third one is negative traits of others. The second question is, how important are my decisions and choices to me? The first option is very important. Second is somewhat important. And the third is not important to me at all. Okay, I can see answers coming in. The third question is, how do I spend most of my spare time? The first option, I usually spend time with myself doing something I like doing. The second is call up friends or family members and have a good conversation. Third one is I would rather take a nap. And third is any other reason. And the last one is multiple, so you can choose how many you want. The fourth question is, what is my biggest fear? The first one is socializing with people online or in person, spending time with my own family, being at home because of the pandemic, and finding time for myself apart from being present in other commitments I have.
Okay, we have only 67% of the attendees voting. 70%, we still have a little time left. Quickly.
I can see even on YouTube, many are answering, but it's different opinions from the youth. Have one more minute. I think most of them have answered. Should we wait longer or should we go on?
85%. 7 people still waiting.
Maybe we can go on.
Yeah.
Okay. So the results for the ones on Zoom will be able to see it, but for YouTube, 78% of the youth from Zoom have said sometimes both positive and negative. And from YouTube, I found many have said the first one, which is positive takes of others. On the second question is, how important are my decisions and choices to me? The youth have answered very important, and I see the same answers on YouTube. It says our decisions are very important. The third one was, how do I spend most of my spare time? 60% of the youth on Zoom said I usually spend time with myself doing something I like, and many on YouTube have said call up friends and family members and have a good conversation. And the last question, where many were given options, which is my biggest fear, the youth found that finding time for myself apart from being present in all other commitments I've made, as well as socializing with people online and offline. And I think that was common answer to both Zoom and YouTube. Over to you.
Thank you so much, Ghislaine. That was a wonderful poll conducted by you for all of us. We really had a greater insight and, you know, got a good understanding about the emotions. Ghislaine, how are you feeling right now?
Actually, to be honest, I feel a bit overwhelmed because I'm loaded with my work and I have a lot of family commitments to be done, and I'm emotionally drained.
I know. That's what all of us are feeling right now. Many of the youth are feeling right now in this situation. But don't worry, we have a few speakers coming up who will enlighten us on how to manage our emotions. So let me introduce you all to our first speaker, Dr. Avinash. He is a dear friend to us. He has helped us during the United World Week 2019 with his expert input session on mental health. We were all physically present together. Dr. Avinash D'Souza is a consultant psychiatrist and physiotherapist. He has consulting rooms in Santa Cruz, Mumbai. He is a research associate at Department of Psychiatry in Mumbai. He is an editor for various mental health journals, and he works as a psychiatrist and counselor in various schools in Mumbai. He is one of the few psychiatrists who is also a master's in counseling and psychotherapy. In 2011, he had been awarded a doctorate in clinical psychology from the University of Hertfordshire, United Kingdom. These are just a few of the many things he does and he is known for. Dr. Avinash is also a great gift to speak to the young people, and therefore we are greatly privileged and grateful to have him with us today.
One last reminder is the Padlet link will be put into the chat and someone will also share it on YouTube. This is where you all can add your questions to Dr. Avinash. Over to you.
Well, good evening, everyone. Am I audible to everyone? Mm-hmm. Yes. Okay. Well, it's a pleasure to be here, and I am always thankful to members of the Focalare group who keep inviting me to various programs. I would like to say just a few things because we have, I think, even another speaker and then questions after that. We are all in unprecedented times. I mean, we first thought last year that, you know, this was a very unprecedented period. I always say it in all my lectures that we initially thought of
COVID and Corona as a nagging mother-in-law that we were all getting used to. And then, you know, after some time, once we got used to it, we got complacent, and the mother-in-law has come again now to, you know, dominate us. So that's how we are. And apart from that, we're not used to being locked in. We're used to being out, free, happy, moving about, doing a lot of things. And it's been a year and a half, nearly 2 years. It'll end, I mean, this year also looks to be going that way, that we'll probably have to be indoors if we have to protect ourselves from this illness. During this phase, well, some of us are lucky that we have very good families. Some of us are lucky that we belong to households where there is harmony and peace. And not everyone in the youth may have that luxury. Some of us may be in houses where there is stress. Some of us may be in families that are dysfunctional. Some of us may be with parents who we sometimes like, sometimes don't like, whose viewpoints we agree with, don't agree with. And there can be a lot of strife and tension in those situations. And the entire, I would say, shift of moving into an online mode, human connection being eliminated to some extent, can play with our emotions. You could feel anger, you could feel shock, you could feel irritability, you could feel sadness, you may feel anxiety, you may feel worry, you may wonder whether the future is going to be the same or different. And I think a lot of our youth are also stuck because their careers are, you know, midway, and they really don't know what direction they're going to take from a career perspective. Many of them have applied abroad for universities and have not been able to go. Some of them thought they would be in the US, UK, Europe studying, but they're studying in their homes online, though they are attached to a university abroad. So this is what has, you know, happened. And apart from this, there are many youth that I have seen who are locked out of their hometowns. They're probably in different cities, alone in this lockdown, facing a lot of stress. Some of them have had to go back to their hometown. Some of them have lost their jobs. Some of them have lost their college admission. So there have been multiple things which have gone wrong. Relationships that they've been in have broken off. New relationships have come in. There have been online relationships, offline relationships, all sorts of things which have taken a toll. And I think most importantly, new friendships have been made. Some old friendships have been broken. Some old friendships have been renewed and maintained. So, you know, there's a huge surge in our lives. And even today, if I ask you, can you think what is going to happen 6 months from now? None of us have a very clear answer. We really don't know whether we can commit to the fact that, yes, in October, things are going to be normal and we're going to be out there. Or is it going to be that, you know, they're talking about a third wave coming in October, November. So, you know, we have all sorts of worries which are on our head. I think there are a few tips which I would want to give to the youth with regard to emotional regulation. The first thing is, understand that you're not alone in this. Everyone is suffering with you. You're not the only person here who's going through this. There's everyone who's going through this. The old, the young, the adults, the children, the teachers, the parents, all of us are in this together. We're all facing the same predicament. Second, I always remember I had a young boy, 19-year-old, who came to my clinic and said, I'm unhappy in this entire lockdown. And, you know, I have to be at home and, you know, be with my parents, and I have to bear them and face them. And I always said, they don't say the same thing about you. You know, they're very happy that you're at home. And they at least feel for the first time you're at home rather than being out the whole day. And so they said, no, it's different. You don't understand. And very often, remember, this is a very good time for you to probably mend some relationships that you could work on. This is a very good time for you to try and understand perspectives. I always tell the youth, you may not always agree with everything that your parents say. You may not always agree with everything that your family members have to offer, but you can take time out to definitely understand their perspective. This is something which is very important. We can differ, we can disagree, but it's important that we respect and understand the other's perspective. This is very important. Third thing is, stay away from negative social media. Stay away from social media that talks about too much of death, too much of dying, too much of negativity. Stay away from social media wherein you spread information that you don't even know is true. Verify the forwards that you send on social media. Verify the forwards that you send on WhatsApp. It's very important that we do not create panic. This is something which I feel is very vital. Fourth, stay in touch with a close group of people who you can be in touch with. Stay in touch with a close group of friends. Online, I won't say offline, today's era, not possible. I wouldn't even advise you to go and meet people because of the current situation. But yes, do stay in touch. Stay in touch with relatives in India, relatives abroad, people here, people abroad who you love and like. That's important. See things which are positive. Don't see movies which are, you know, very violent and aggressive and are going to make you cry. It's very important that you see things that make you laugh. You'll automatically feel a sense of positivity. Take this time out to learn something new. Anything that you wanted to learn all this while but didn't have the time to. Today, everything is available online. So you can learn something new and probably hone and harness your talent in that direction. Write about what you feel. Maintain a diary. Write a journal. Write about what you feel. Write experiences, what you've learned from people around you. Even if there is a death of someone close to you, write about your feelings for that person. It's something which is very important for you to reflect on maybe 5 years from now. It'll be a very useful book to make you understand how I was and how I have matured over time. Last but not the least, if you feel upset, depressed, sad, anxious, worried, and don't know what to do, please do not hesitate to seek help from a mental health professional. Those who can afford help, help is available. Those who cannot afford help, there are free helplines available. Those who have an issue with regard to fees, there are multiple portals available where you can go and seek help. But be ready to seek help. Do not think, oh, I will be labeled, I will be diagnosed, I'll be medicated, I will be doped. No, don't think that way. Think, I must visit a psychiatrist for myself. I must visit a psychologist for myself. It's very good for my own mental health. And now I have the time to do it. So let me do it. If you come across anyone amongst you who says, you know, life is not worth living and feels suicidal, feels upset. And I'm saying this because it's a very important issue in the youth. Please grab him, pull him and take him to a mental health professional. It's very important. Don't give him a number and tell him, contact the person. You contact the person, take the appointment and see that he is there. This is very important because there's a lot of hesitancy. There's a lot of, you know, reluctance to seek help for mental health. So please make sure that people close to you having mental health problems seek help. I always, as a psychiatrist, say, I don't believe in labels and I don't believe in diagnosis. I believe in intervention and treatment because we generally first name a disorder and then we shame it. So once we say you have depression, then we say I have a friend who's depressive. I always say the terminology you use is very important. You never have people who are anxious. You have people who suffer from anxiety. You never have people who are depressed and depressive. You have people who suffer from depression. You never have people who are schizophrenic. They're people who suffer from schizophrenia. So these are individuals suffering from an illness. Let's give some dignity to mental health. It's very important. And similarly, there are people who tell me, I have a parent who's alcoholic. I have a father who drinks, who gets violent. And I always say, your father isn't alcoholic. He suffers from alcohol dependence. So it's a condition that is medical. Let's medicalize it. Let's treat it. Let's not look at it in any other way. And do whatever makes you happy. One man's noise is another man's music. Listen to whatever music you like. Listen to whatever you want. Do whatever you like. That's very important. And if you need any help, we're always here to help you. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Avinash, for your presentation and valuable contributions today. We are indeed very grateful to have you. We are now will have a question and answer round for you who have questions and have put it in panel. John, do we have any questions on panel?
No questions as yet. It's not in the packet.
Okay, do we have anyone who would like to ask a question to Dr. Avinash? For the ones on YouTube, you all can type it down into the YouTube chat and we make sure we read it out.
I would like to ask a question. Yeah.
So I want to ask you, when someone is sick and confides in you, do you listen, like you have to listen to them, but then do you, how would you react to, for them to go and take help, like, to make them realize? Because sometimes people don't want to listen to the fact they are not well. And then you can take them there, but most importantly is the denial of the fact that you're not mentally unwell. So what would you say about that?
Okay, one of the things which I would want to say here is that, you know, very often I tell people, don't tell your friends that we think, you know, you have depression or we think you have anxiety. Don't label them. Tell them that, you know, let's seek professional help on this. And if the professional feels that, yes, you have an issue, then we seek further help. Let me not be the one to diagnose you, but I think this is a problem which is a little beyond me. As a friend, I can probably support you, but I can't advise you or guide you on this. So therefore, you know, I would want to take you to someone who I know, who's a professional, who can be of help in helping us trying to find out what needs to be done here. And always tell them, come once. If later you want to follow the advice, don't want to follow the advice, follow half of it, that's a personal choice. But let's go and, you know, at least seek help and clarity on what the issue is, so that then we can probably take that further from there.
Thank you. We have a question from YouTube. The question is, what are the charges for therapy sessions and how do we know which therapist is correct for?
Okay, so like I said, you have a variety of therapy options. You know, just like you can have tea at a tea stall on the road and you can have tea in a 5-star hotel and the tea tastes equally good. So you have therapists and therapy sessions available at various places. You can have people who are in private practice who, if you can afford fees, you could go there. There are NGOs that offer therapy for free. There are helplines that offer therapy for free. There are initiatives run by the church that offer therapy for free. And there are psychologists over there who sort of are available for these services. So it's your personal call. How do you, you know, want to go about it? Therapy, even at a concessional rate, is offered by most mental health professionals. And I mean, you could definitely speak to them. And yes, it will have to be at a time suitable to you and to the professional both. But I think therapy is available. So if charges are an issue and you can't afford charges, my number and my email are here. Get in touch with me. I'll see that you get a therapist who can, you know, fit into either the charge that you can afford, or if you really can't afford anything, then we get you to an NGO that can offer you therapy free of charge.
Okay, I think we have a Padlet question coming in. So the question is, how do we manage our emotions by not letting others or their actions affect it, especially if your family is one that constantly nags you?
Okay, if you have a family that is constantly upsetting you, irritating you, nagging you, I think you need to sit down and, you know, talk to them and tell them very clearly what about them upsets you. If they're not ready to seek help, you go to a therapist, seek help, seek advice. If needed, have one session where the entire family visits the therapist and get some insight. I very often have seen that sometimes the youth or the adolescent or the teenager telling the family doesn't work, but maybe me as a doctor telling them or a therapist telling them sometimes has that added positive effect and they listen. If all family members are not amenable to suggestion, then we get hold of the family member that is most amenable to suggestion. So it could be one family member who the person is closer to. We get that person involved so that his team strength increases within the family, and then we try and look at how things can be managed.
I think we have time for one more question.
For one more question? Okay. Are there any home remedies and exercises for depression?
Well, sadly, we don't have home remedies. But yes, you can look at meditation, mindfulness, yoga. There are all sorts of things you can do at home. Read positive things, read positive books. But if that doesn't work, then you probably need to seek professional help.
Thank you, Dr. Avina, so much for your valuable contribution, and we indeed are very grateful to have you with us today.